I'm Mike Ginter. Join me on this exciting journey of exploring high-risk, high-performing flight operations, where pilots and crews push themselves and their aircraft to the edge of performance and do it safely. In this episode, I'm flying with the TITAN Aerobatic Team during EAA AirVenture 2024 to explore how they're able to safely perform aerobatics in such close proximity. The TITAN team are highly experienced and trained professional pilots who have flown together for several decades. I had the unique opportunity to interview and fly with the TITAN team to explore how they execute their tight formation aerobatics routine with such precision and do it safely year after year.
And now you guys do a little bit different formation stuff. You have different qualifications, you're flying at air shows, it's in wavered airspace. How's that different from me and my buddy flying formation tomorrow and a couple of bonanzas?
Mainly, I mean, we're doing formation acro. You know, it's a big difference between flying standard formation and flying acro. We have to change a lot of ways. It's like a horse on a racetrack. We cut to the inside and do certain things that you wouldn't normally do.
So you're flying a 5,000-pound airplane, a big radial engine, in close formation, in aerobatics, and you're not doing it like everybody else flies formation. You're stepped up.
Let me make sure people understand this. Do never, ever go do what we're doing when we stack up like that. That was developed over years. Every formation clinic, you go to NATA, you go to any formation clinic, they are not going to want you to do that.
No.
And so don't go do that.
I've had people that were highly trained formation, but they were like, what are you doing going up? What are you doing? Because they've never done that before. I said, ours is a choreographed routine. It's a dance that we repeat over and over and over.
The TITAN team does not fly a standard formation position. The two wingmen fly stepped up on the leader's aircraft, which means they are above the leader's wing line. In a standard formation, the wingman flies stepped down below the leader's wing line, which provides an element of safety when the leader turns into the wingman. You'll see how the TITAN wingman established this stepped-up position immediately after takeoff and remain in that position throughout the performance.
Hey, we're on our takeoff roll, Mike. Full forward pressure. Got the tail up going through 60. There's 70. There's 80. A little bit of back pressure. We're up. Positive brake. Tap the brakes. Gears coming up. Right turn.
The takeoff sequence is carefully planned and executed, completing the checklist, cleaning up the aircraft, and communicating the next move to the wingman, all performed smoothly and predictably.
You may remind me, what's the first maneuver we're going to do?
We're going to do a loop, and then follow my wing over to the right, and a barrel roll to the left.
Steve and Brian remain stepped up as Jimmy positions the flight for the loop. It's easy to see the relative motion between the three aircraft as the wingmen make minute corrections to stay in exactly the right position.
Okay, a little left turn, we're going to work this hole right here, nose coming down. Go smoke now.
The G's build and I can feel the forces increasing on my body until I weigh four times my normal weight.
Over the top, let it run.
Coming out of the loop, Jimmy enters the wing over to the right and both wingmen remain in their stepped up positions.
Coming up, let the nose come down, roll it out.
As the Titan team enters the barrel roll to the left, you'll see Steve step down for the initial onset of G-force and then reposition to the inside of the leader's flight path by stepping up. This helps Steve maintain the correct nose-to-tail distance by decreasing the radius of his flight path and closing the gap. Having flown this thousands of times, each member of the Titan team knows when to expect each maneuver. They instinctively know when a little power addition is all that is needed, or perhaps adding a little power plus a change from stepped up to stepped down position to increase or decrease their radius of turn, therefore maintain correct nose to tail distance throughout the complex maneuvers.
Oshkosh, Titan, Warbird Island.
3-2 green.
2-2 green.
4-2 green.
You can see your adherence to discipline checklist is ingrained in memory, and you don't skip stuff.
We like the gear call.
Oh, absolutely.
I always tell myself before I'm landing that I'm landing a T6.
Yeah, right.
Because it does get kind of squirrely sometimes. We'll land on 3-6 right, and then we'll have a kind of a long taxi. You see the guys up ahead of us up here that are departing 3-6 left, and they're making a turn
over the four lane circuit
right over our runway, but we'll be well below them and on the ground before we get to where they're at.
So you'd have to keep an eye on those in case you had to do a go around.
Exactly. And a gas, undercarriage, mixture, and the prop is set for the go around. Full flap, and we're just driving down the runway to get past the green
traffic.
Dot.
Traffic.
And then we'll set it down here in just a second, and we'll go to the end.
You're keeping the tail up now.
Tail up.
DC3, I need you to start your descent on IM traffic over top of you from 5th. They're going to be landing the skinny runway. I need you to start your descent.
Traffic.
You can
traffic.
3-6 left.
I can see you dancing on those rudders. That's a typical T6 thing, isn't it?
Over the 4 lane. Keep it high for me. You're going to be overflying a DC3 on final for 3-6 left.
So would you say this is a typical tail dragger and landing configuration, or is it something different about the T6?
Well, it's always trying to, it seems like, kill you. It likes to depart one way or another, and that's the reason you saw my feet dancing on the rudder pedals real hard.
That was very
because
evident,
of, you know, I want to be sure those rudder pedals are, first of all, working, and second of all, that they're doing what I want them to do when I want them to do it, and that's very important.
I mean, if you were telling somebody who's just a regular pilot, how do you keep that edge and do what you're doing so well at such a high performance level all the time?
Yeah, we fly a lot of air shows. I mean, we're flying 20, 25 events. That keeps you tuned in. You know, the Blues and the Thunderbirds, they change, they revolve pilots every 2 years.
Yep.
And so we're together year after year after year.
That's right.
And flying that many times, it keeps you, your performance level up pretty good without you even trying. But you know, we strive to be the best we could be, and we all critique each other really hard. That's one thing about being a member on this team. If you can't take criticism, you're in the wrong spot, because we all criticize each other. If we see anything
screws up, it'll get interesting.
But it makes you a better pilot to be able to take criticism, and you need to always be willing to take criticism and learn from that.
If you can't take criticism, I said, just think about this. If you can sit on a pineapple without making a face, then you're just right for us.
Yeah.
Flying with the Titan team was an incredible experience, and it allowed me to observe firsthand their culture of safety. This culture was completely second nature for each of the pilots. I witnessed discipline, professionalism, intense focus, and their commitment to excellence. They were humble, yet they displayed these traits in everything they did on the ground and in the air. They demanded excellence from themselves and from their teammates. They have fun as a team, yet they are acutely aware that there is no room for any mistakes. I gained immense respect for how hard the Titan team works when performing air shows, especially a 7-day show like Oshkosh. They work on their safety culture, and they also rely on it at the same time. As GA pilots, we also fly in an environment that demands a strong culture of safety. Whether we're getting current after a long break from flying, or flying the most demanding ILS approach to minimums at night, we must do so with discipline, professionalism, focus, and a commitment to excellence. There is no room for complacency when flying a demanding formation aerobatic routine, and the same is true when we fly our GA aircraft.